Charlie, you've got to be pleased with that performance today, I would imagine.
Oh, absolutely delighted with the performance. From start to finish, I felt we were the stronger team. And I didn't think at any point during the game we were under any sort of sustained pressure. I mean, my goalkeeper had probably the easiest 90 minutes he's ever going to have. He didn't even get himself or the kit dirty, which is a testament to the 10 guys playing in front of him. I mean, I thought our work rate and our desire to stop opposition playing was unquestionable today, and I think that was the catalyst for our thirdly deserved 3-0 performance.
Yeah, the first goal was a bit long in coming though, wasn't it? Lossie defended very well in that first 20 minutes or so.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I thought we were dominant in possession and played all the first 25 minutes in their half, as you said, and it was a worry when the goal didn't come. With a scenario exactly the same last year, we were dominant for the first half an hour last year and had 10 corners and failed to capitalise, and we got beat 4-0 that day last year. So I was pleased to get the first one, and for then on I think it was only a matter of time when we got the second, and obviously getting the second, they had to come out a wee bit and get the sending off, and the third just capped it off, and it could have been more in the end really.
Yeah, I think the goal of the afternoon is going to be that first goal, that opening goal. What a way to open the score, man.
Absolutely. I mean, Kevin's got the ability. He's probably technically the most gifted at the club by a kind of a country mile. And I mean, it was a difficult ball coming out, and he cut across it beautifully, and it was just sailing at top corner. Although I think the goalkeeper did make a valiant effort to try and stop it. But a great finish, and it sort of, it got us off and running and gave us that wee bit extra confidence.
I don't think I could understate just how important that win was today, with so many games being off. It was like playing one of your games in hand, basically.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, and we spoke about it before the game. It was one of our games in hand, given the Cove games off. So it was really, really important to come to a difficult venue against a real good quality side, given their league position, and come away with 3-0 wins above our expectations, but thoroughly deserved, I felt.
I think it's a good way to finish a week that was pretty horrendous in terms of the injury to young Fraser. That was a real bad one.
Yeah. I mean, we're all still trying to go over it, if I'm being honest. I mean, more so for Lee than for the club. I mean, we didn't like to see that to happen to any of our players or any individual for that matter, that's involved in football. But if Remdy can come through it and come back stronger, I'm sure it'll be Lee Fraser.
Charlie, what can you say after a game like that?
There's lots to say, but it all sounds like excuses. You know, Forest beat us fair and square, and I think the job was made easier for him as the game went on due to our injuries, and I to be fair to him, to go back to the first half, the formation messed us about a little bit, and it's always going to be very difficult to deal with it. And the goals have changed games. The first goal, you know, it was always a case of keeping it clean to the second half, and we kind of had a bit of a rash challenge to give away the free kick. Everything we've talked about, you know, the emphasis is always on speaking about how set pieces and corners you're giving away to Forest and stuff like that. And that kind of led to the first goal, so that was disappointing. But as the game went on, we've had to plug holes with strikers in wide areas, strikers in midfield. You know, Gary McDonald out, JJ struggling, Martin struggling at the end, Priefty suspended. you know, I'm not looking for, it sounds like looking for excuses, but and Coco with his hamstring, you know, that's people right across the midfield, and it showed in the end.
Yeah, I think the first 25 minutes, Lossie kept it fairly tight. It's fair to say that Forrest was on the ascendancy at that point, but Lossie kept it tight. There weren't too many chances, but it was a goal, and a wonderful goal.
Hi. No complaints. You know, I've got complaints with the build-up to a goal. It shouldn't be, that situation shouldn't have arisen. You know, it did, and that's what Forest are all about. You know, I've no complaints with that, but we needed to get into wide areas a bit better, and Nicky was a bit isolated. Scotty was in the hole to try and create something from there. So, you know, and it was just very difficult. You know, despite all the hype and recent results at Grant Park against Forest, you know, I knew that we were going to be taking on a team today that had gone up another level from last year as well, and like you say, they're riding high in confidence. Charlie's not had to tweak stuff much with his players, I don't think, you know, and that's a warning sign, because that means he's got plenty in reserve as well, you know. And in the end, it was just a case of closing the thing out and not giving away too many goals.